Thank you. That's fantastic, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you. I want to make one thing clear. Let me make something clear. I've been singing that song for a long time. Just a minute here. I've been singing that song for a long time. And a lot of people kind of got it associated with me because they think it's a personal thing. It is not. It's a beautiful song written by Marty Robbins. And I heard Frankie Lane do it, I think it was. And I just love the song. And it has nothing to do with me personally. My ex-wife, Priscilla, she's right here. Honey, stand up. Come out, Johnny. Come out. Come on out. Turn around and let them see you. Let them see you. Boy, she's a beautiful chick, I'll tell you for sure, boy. Boy, I knows them when I pick someone, you know. God damn. Now, show my little daughter, Lisa. She's 6 years old. Look at her jump up. Put your dress down, Lisa. You pull your dress down before you jump up like that again, young lady. And then at the same booth is my girlfriend, Sheila. Stand up, Sheila. Turn around, completely around. Sheila, straight up. Hold her ring up. The ring, your right hand. Look at that son of a bitch. Now, the thing I'm trying to get across is we're the very best of friends, and we always have been. Our divorce came about not because of another man or another woman, but because of the circumstances involving my career. I was traveling too much. I was gone too much. And it was just an agreement that I didn't think it was fair to her because I was gone so much and everything. So I, therefore, as decently as you can do that type of thing, we just made an agreement to her to always be friends and be close and care because we have a daughter to raise and for her to have whatever she wanted as a settlement. After the settlement, and it came out and about $2 million, you know. Well, after that, I got her a mink coat. I know it. I'm talking about the mink coat. You hang loose over there. The XKE Jag, after the song, just gave it to her. She got me, listen to this, tonight, a $42,000 white Rolls Royce. That's the type of relationship that we have, you know, and it's not a bad setup, is it, fellas? You know, I mean, I got part of it back anyway, did I? I wasn't hurting too bad, but I mean, I did get part of it back. You know, she bought the car just out of a gesture of love, and she likes the studs that I have. It's not a car, it's a studs. No. God, help me. No, it's called a stud. A studs. And she likes a stud. She likes his studs. Mike Stone ain't no stud, so forget it. She liked his studs. And so I'm gonna give her the studs and she can give me the rope. Stone, but I wish he was a stud, you know. He's a nice guy. I'd like to do a song here, ladies and gentlemen, that is one of the prettiest goddamn love songs I've heard in my life, man, I'll tell you. No, it is. It's just one of the prettiest songs I've ever heard in my life. I've never sung it. I've never recorded it. I never liked the damn thing until I found out. Damn, I got a toothache. Until I found out the story behind why it was written, and then I really didn't like it because I don't like that type of stuff. So the next song, no. Now, this is a true story of a song. It's been around for a long time. Try to take his belt out, really. He's going to cut me, castrate me, do something, you know. Really, I can't do that. I got things to do and places, you know, places to go and other tours and things and secret cities and chicks and all that jazz, you know. Look, I just can't. Be careful. Be careful, son. Be careful. Don't get it caught in the cord. I'll die, you know. Electrocute my ass. And I mean, excuse me, folks. I just mumble things. Oh! Damn, I said, that tight? You cut off my hair, man. I can't sing. You know, I sing from down in the gut. Any round, shoe soles. It'll never get up here. I want to tell you a story, if you don't mind, before I do this. So this little young lady right here, her name is Judy Spreckles. And let me tell you a story about her. When I came to Hollywood, I was 20 years old, to do Love Me Tender. Her family was the Spreckles Sugar family. You've heard of those, haven't you? Yeah, well, I guess everybody has because, you know, it's a big company. She gave me Black Star Sapphire ring that I kept up until Priscilla and I were married, and Priscilla used it as an engagement ring. This lady right here did, 20 years ago. Judy Spreckles. I don't know where she's been. She's been married off in the hills, flying into jets and climbing trees and all kinds of stuff. Yeah. Riding horses. She's a wild woman, you know, but she did that, and she comes around every once in a while to check on me. You know. So anyway, let me tell you about this song, all kidding aside. It's the story of a man who's dying in a hospital. And his wife had been sitting by his bedside for 3 days and three nights. Somewhere on the third night, between midnight and day, she lay down beside him and dozed off to sleep softly, Glenn. Lay down beside him and dozed off to sleep. Well, he felt her when she dozed off to sleep. And I hope you'd quit writing it, Lassus, that I'll tell a story, please. He was dying, and he felt her when she lay down beside him. And he didn't want her to see him pass away. So he took his notepad from the side of the bed, and he very quietly wrote, "Softly, I will leave you.
I will leave
softly,
softly,
for my heart would break.
For my heart would break
if you should wake.
If you should wake
and see me go.
And see me go.
So I leave you.
So I'll leave you
softly,
softly.
Long before you miss me.
Before you miss me.
Long before your arms
can
make me stay.
Can make me stay.
For one more hour.
For one more.
For one more day.
For one more day."
He said, "After all the years.
After all.
Bear the tears.
I can't bear the tears
to fall.
To fall.
So softly.
So softly.
So softly.
I will leave you there. I will leave you."
Thank you very much. I couldn't ask for a better audience in the world, believe me. You're out of sight. That was Cheryl Nielsen singing in the background. Fantastic, son. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. God. Okay.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time. Well, you ain't never gonna run, and you ain't no friend. Ain't nothing but a hound, crying all the time. Ain't nothing but a hound, crying all the time. Well, you ain't gonna have it and you ain't no friend. Ain't nothing but a hound, crying all the time. Ain't nothing but a hound, crying all the time. Well, you ain't never gonna have it and you ain't no friend. Ain't nothing but a hound, crying all the time. Ain't nothing but a hound.
Ain't never gonna very much. Well, we lucked out on that deal. I'm not kidding you. Let's do. No, no, honey. Let's do Trilogy. Okay. Turn the light back up, please. Choke this belt, Charlie. This son of a bitch got a mind of its own, man. I mean, he just crawls where he wants to go, you know. No, no, leave it alone. Just hook it. Hook it, Charlie. Hook it, wild man. Oh! Not too hard. I had to deal with the bathroom, yeah. Oh, I wish... Oh, I wish I was in the land of cotton. Old times they are, and I've forgotten. Look away, Lord, look away. Look away, Lord, Dixieland. Sing it, fellas.
Oh, I wish I was in Dixie.
I wish you were too.
Away.
I was born early, Lord, Lord, one frosty morn. Look away, Lord, look away, look away, Dixieland. Smile so tender, my heart was captured, my soul surrendered. I waited a lifetime, waiting for the right time. now that you're here, the time is here. That love is now or never. Come hold me tight. Kiss me, my darling. Be mine tonight. Just like a willow, we would cry in ocean if we lost true love and sweet devotion. Your lips excite me, let you overlove me. Oh, who knows when we'll meet again this way. Thank you very much. Oh, you're out of sight. You are fantastic. Thank you. Boy, I tell you what, really, I couldn't have gotten a better audience if I'd stood out there and paid everybody $20 to come in here. I really couldn't have. You are out of sight, boy. I'd like to introduce you to the members of my group before we go any further. First of all, the young ladies you met are in the show tonight. They've been with me for 5 years tonight. Sweet Inspirations. Some of the finest voices in the world, they've been with me 4 years tonight. J.D. Sumner and the Stamps Quartet. I'd like to introduce each one of these fellas to you because they're the only ones that don't get introduced, with the exception of the big band, and there's too many of them over there, except my friend Giggles over here. Look at him, man. He's jolly. He's jolly, man. And a little Indian, the Indian boy down here. Look at him. Look at this little cat, man. He's turned profile. He was on the head of a nickel. Bill Cosby, he was on the head of a nickel, I'm telling you, man, you know. His grandfather was. Hey, hey, hey. Anyway, singing the baritone from Nashville, Tennessee is Ed Hill. Singing the lead, one of the strongest voices I've ever heard, is Ed Enoch. Way over there singing a high tenor, and I mean he's high, boy, is Bill Bays. The little girl that does her high voice singing, she's with the Metropolitan Opera for a year, and she has a beautiful voice. She works on all my records. Her name is Kathy Westmore. On the lead guitar, ladies and gentlemen, one of the funkiest chicken-picking son of a guns you've ever met in your life, from down in Shreveport, Louisiana, James Burton. Just pick a little something, James. Just listen to this dude, man. Listen to him. Go ahead, talk some more, man. Talk. Stand rock, stand rock. No jazz, stand rock. get him a shaft. Guitar from Springfield, Missouri, John Wilkerson. On the drums from down in Dallas, Texas is Ronnie Tutt. Play, Ronnie. Take it on. Take it on. Yeah, nothing but time. Take it on. Get on it, team. Play Fender Bass Duke Bardwell. Play something, Duke. Play it, Duke. Talk to me, son. Talk to me. Play it, Duke. Come on, come on, come on. Walk on it, walk on it, walk on it. Get dirty. Louisiana, man. My alligator's in your hair. Come on. Louisiana, son, there's an alligator bait down there. Come on. Come on. Ha! Ah. You know, you got your grand. Duke Bardwell. Turn Lindy's amp up. Down in Lubbock, Texas, on the turn his amp up. Lubbock, Texas, on the piano, Lindy Harden. Wait, lady. Alabama, Charlie Hodge. Fellas have been with me for about a year. Cool it for a second. Just hold the music. They've been with me for about a year, and they opened a show tonight, but I'm going to ask them to do a song. Is Pete backstage? Did you do that without you tonight? Would you do that for me? Pete? Pete, are you here? Kid from Sweden, where is he? Come here, son. This guy's from Sweden, ladies and gentlemen, that plays the piano. And I mean, he will make, most of the piano players. Hey, hello, Pete, there he is. Hey, you guys do that song, I Know I Couldn't Live Without You. Come on, use my microphone and Charlie's. Okay? Get a Peter mic and use mine and Charlie's. I want them to hear this song. Pete wrote this song, ladies and gentlemen. It's called I Can't Live Without You.
Look out, look out.
He needs a microphone. Song you do the lead on? No, not Killing Me Softly.
Okay, I did. Killing Me Softly. Have you done that earlier?
We did earlier?
I don't know. Okay. Do that one. Bringing It Back.
This isn't a song too far. So you'll hear these later on record.
Right now they're brand new.
I could never see. I could never hold you. I could never touch your face or feel your warm embrace. I still remember talking. I still remember laughing. And I still remember loving a lot. Just touching you. Maybe I've not forgot.
Everything's bringing it by. You know it's just bringing it by. A familiar place, for a familiar place just brings it all by. Everything's bringing it by. Good songs bringing it by. You even after so much time, you know everything's bringing it by. Thinking in my solitude, wondering about your attitude. I'm thinking maybe that your love has died. There it is, I can see it in your eyes. And your touch of sweet surrender, with a touch of too much sadness. Cause I hurt you so, you know your sorrow shows. And you just can't stay, but you know that you can't let go. Cause everything's bringing it by. You know it's just bringing it by. A familiar place or a familiar face just brings it all by.
Put on the bass.
Everything's bringing it by. Good songs bringing it by. Everything's bringing it by. But everything's bringing it by. Good songs bringing it by. And even after so much time, you know everything's bringing it by.
Wait a minute, hold it. Listen to him. Listen to him do. Can you just Pete play Aubrey?
Yeah.
Okay, listen to Shirley one more and then we'll go on what we're doing, okay? I want him to do a song called Aubrey. This was got by a group called Bread. But they ain't ever sung like this cat has.
And Aubrey was a name. But not so very ordinary girl. But who's to blame for a love that wouldn't bloom for the hearts that never played in tune? Like a lovely melody that everyone can see. Take away the words that rhyme, it doesn't mean a thing. And Aubrey was a name. We tripped the night and danced together to the moon. But where's June? No, it if it did, it never made a sound. Maybe I was absent, I was listening too fast, catching all the words within, the meaning going past. And how I missed a girl, and I'd go 1,000 miles around the world to be closer to her than to me. And Aubrey was a
girl. I never knew her.
I never knew her.
But I loved her just the same.
But I loved her just the same.
I loved her name.
I loved her name. Wish that I'd found a way, and the reasons I could make her stay.
I've learned a little life.
I have learned to lead a life
apart from all the rest.
Apart from all the rest.
If I can't have,
if I can have the one I want,
I'll do without the rest.
I'll do without the rest.
And God.
And God, I must go. And I'd go a million times around the world just to say she had been mine for a day.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, fellas. You're fantastic. And Pete, thank you. It was beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to share with you some of the talent that we have up on the stage here. And, you know, if you dig it, we'll share different things with you, and I'll sing some more songs. And this is our last show. We don't care. These fellas are from Nashville, and I call them Voice. And you see why. Our conductor from Las Vegas is Mr. Joe Gershaw. Joe is conducting the fantastic Joe Gershaw Orchestra. This orchestra, ladies and gentlemen, was voted by Billboard magazine in the last 2 years the number one orchestra of the year. Cost me a fortune to get that done. No, I'm only kidding. There's a guy in the audience. I got sick one night last week and I had a temperature of about 102. Wait a minute. Don't applaud me, 102 temperature. No, I had a temperature. It was a flu going on in this town and all my employees were dropping like flies. And I was in, they were in a room with me, you know, getting me dressed and they breathing in my face. And so I caught the flu and I missed one night, which I don't like to do. I've only missed about 6-7 nights in 19 years from illness, you know. That's because to me, a germ is an enemy, and I hate that son of a bitch, and I'll fight it, you know. And that's why I went to the hospital. Went to the hospital once in my life. Once in my life. And then it was only for 3 days because they had a little bronchial trouble in the tubes. And they, you know how they do in a hospital, they check you for everything in the world, man. I mean, liver, you know, they'll find something wrong with you. They'll create something if you ain't got it. That guy took a liver biopsy. You know what a liver test is? You know what a liver, you know what it do? The doctor comes in and says, don't look at me. Turns your head. Takes a needle this long, goes right between your ribs, pulls out a piece of your liver. I swear to God, that's it. John, you know what I'm talking about. And so I said, he said, I don't move for 24 hours. And here I was, I guess. Damn, what did he do to me? I was okay, I was getting well, and he come in and stabbed me. I swear to God, I saw him in the corner of my eye because I can't help it, I'm trained that way. He looked like a samurai warrior. He said, ta-da! Put that needle, man, you know. Fastest sandwich I've ever seen in my life, boy. Anyway, when I got sick, a fellow volunteered his services to come in and fill in for me. He was way up north somewhere working or getting a TV show. He does so much. He volunteered to come in and work this show for me. And now that he's been here ever since, he'll open here tomorrow night. I'd like to thank him, Bill Cosby. Bill, where are you, buddy? What? Where's Bill? I haven't seen Bill yet. Where's Cosby? You mean after that buildup, that son of a bitch left? Well, the hell with him. I won't pay him anyway. No, I'm only kidding. No, he gets 10 grand. I give him that whether he likes it or not. I stick it up his nose. There's a lady in the audience I'd like to introduce you to. She's been in to see my show twice before. The reason we have a mutual respect is because the only way we know how to sing is from the gut out, both of us. And you know who I'm talking about? Her name is Vicky Carr. Turn around, baby. Turn around. Turn around. There you go. Yeah. And she's working. You're working where, honey? She's working at the Tropicana. You didn't change. It's okay. Don't make excuses to me. Sit down. No. Thank you, Vicky. But anyway, did you hear It's Now or Never? Did you hear the song It's Now or Never? Oh, God. Now I got to do it again. It's Now or Never.
When I first saw you with your smile so tender, my heart was captured, my soul surrendered. I waited a lifetime, waiting for you every time. Now that you're here, time is here, and be mine tonight. Tomorrow we'll be here. It's now or never, my love. Just like a willow, you cry emotion. If we lost true love and sweet devotion, your lips excite me, let your arms invite me. For who knows when we'll meet again this way. It's now or never, come home with time. Kiss me, my darling, be mine tonight. Put them on.
Done it once, but we did it again. Oh dear.
Fine.
Wherever you go, wherever you may wander in your life, surely you know, girl, I always wanna be there, holding your hand and standing by to protect you when you fall. Seeing you through, through everything you do.
Yeah, let me be there in your morning. Let me be there in your night.
Yeah,
let me change whatever's wrong and make it right.
Make it right.
Yeah, let me take you to that wonderland.
Let me be there.
Let me be there.
grow and going through the changes in your life. That's how I know. That's how I always wanna be there.
Whenever you feel you need a friend to lean on, here I am. Whenever you call, you know I'll be there. Let me be there in your night.
Yeah.
Let me change whatever's wrong and make it right.
Yeah.
Make it right.
Yeah. Let me take you to
that wonderland that I want you to get shared.
Yeah.
All I ask you,
oh, let me be there. Fantastic audience, thank you. Woo. Okay. Okay, walk in your sleep.
We'll be right back. easier tomorrow. Give I see it away. Kevin, what'd you say? Hog in your sleep. I want you my name.
I want you my name.
Baby.
Hog in your sleep.
Forget where you came.
Forget where you came.
I want you my name.
Don't mention 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 my name.
Yeah. Talk in your sleep. Don't mention my name.
Thank you very much. Lord have mercy. Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like you to meet one of the fellows who promoted me to the 8th degree black. His name is Ed Parker. He has about 18 kenpo schools around the country. Ed Parker. There's another fellow in the audience. See that book. This friend of mine, his name is John O'Grady. He's written a book. He was head of the narco squad in Los Angeles for 26 years. And on the 166th page, he's got about three pages about me and my ex-wife, Priscilla, and about our friendship, and about that maternity suit. It turned out to be a complete conspiracy and a hoax, man. You know, just no way. I had a picture made with that chick, and it's all. I mean, she got pregnant with a camera, a Polaroid or something. But anyway, it's all in this book. It's and watching Polaroid cameras, boy. But you know what she did? And when she goofed up, she named the night. And the night that she named, my wife was with me in the audience. And that's the night she said, "Ain't no way I'm gonna fool around with her out there. You kidding me?" So anyway, let me tell you something. If you like things like the French Connection, the Chinese Connection, the British Connection, the knee connection to the jump bone, bone neck to. If you like that type of stuff, buy this book. It's called O'Grady. It'll be in print when, John? Up to September 27th. It will fascinate you. It's about 26 years of a hardline policeman working in the narco squad out of Hollywood. So you can imagine what it's like. By this book, it's called O'Grady. Okay. John just came back from New York, where he had a meeting of this. I have been a member of this organization for 5 years, the International Narcotics Enforcement Officers Association, in recognition of the outstanding loyalty and contribution to the support of narcotic law enforcement. This award of special honor is bestowed upon Elvis Presley in testimony, so and so. Lifetime member in the International Narcotics Enforcement Officers Association. So I just got that. So, I don't pay any attention to rumors. I don't pay any attention to movie magazines. They don't read them because they're all junk. And, I don't mean to put anybody's job down. I'm talking about they have a job to do, and they got to write something. So if they don't know anything, they make it up, you know. So in my case, they make it up. When I hear rumors flying around, I got sick in the hospital. Well, I was, you know, in this day and time, you can't even get sick. You are strung out. Oh, by God, I'll tell you something, friend. I have never been strung out in my life except on music. When I got sick here in the hotel, I got sick here that one night. I had 102 temperature. They wouldn't let me perform. From three different sources, I heard I was strung out on heroin. I swear to God, hotel employees, Jack, bellboys, freaks that carry your luggage up to the room, people working around, you know, talking, maids. And I was sick. I was, you know, I was getting, had a doctor, had the flu, and I got over one day, was I? But all across this town, I was strung out. So I told him earlier, and don't you get offended, ladies and gentlemen, I'm talking to somebody else. If I find or hear the individual that has said that about me, I'm going to break your goddamn neck, you son of a bitch. That is dangerous. That is damaging to myself, to my little daughter, to my father, to my friends, my doctor, to everybody in my relationship with you, my relationship with up here on the stage. It is dangerous. I will pull your goddamn tongue out by the roots. Thank you very much. Anyway, how many of you people saw the movie Blue Hawaii? Probably the most requested song. Let me get out of this mood. Probably the most requested song in that movie was the Hawaiian wedding songs. Let me do that for you.
This is the moment I've waited for. I can hear my heart singing.
Blah, 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 blah.
Soon we'll be ringing. This is the moment of love, sweet hello. I will love you long and forever.
That's beautiful, honey. Thank you.
Promise me that you...
I take this and I'm strung out. Honey, you don't mind if I use it to show it, do you?
All my love. Promise me that you will leave me never. I will love you long and forever. Now that we are one, clouds won't hide the sun. Blue skies, a Hawaii smile on this our wedding day. I do love you, with all my Hawaii.
Thank you. Let me show you something for those of you who may not be too observant, you know, or might have missed. I'm not going to embarrass Kathy, but I'm going to show you what I was doing to her then. She was having to sing on microphone. Come here. No, I want to. So I'm singing. I do love you. Watch my left hand.
With all watch. My
that's exactly what I was doing. She had tears in her eyes. Like that. Oh, Lord have mercy. Fantastic. I'd like to thank my engineer, Mr. Bill Porter, who handles all this sound down here. Bill? I'd like you folks to meet my father. He's in the audience somewhere. I'd like him to stand up. Dad, where are you? Daddy, come out here a minute. Come out. There he is, right there. Thank you, Daddy. My manager, Colonel Tom Parker, where is he? Is the Colonel around anywhere? Oh, he's out playing roulette. Don't kid me. I know what he's doing. Him and Cosby out there talking mash and drinking trash or whatever. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, I want to tell you a little bit about this jury that I got on. No, I can't sing about the jury. Hell, you know, these rocks. Now, this thing I got up wore in the Hawaii special, you know, and people thought it was one big... one big stone, and it's not. It's 11.5 carat stone, which is pretty big, you know. It's the biggest I've ever seen. And anyway, this next to Elizabeth, I think she's got the biggest one. I think you're right. And that's the biggest diamond, too. You're fast. You're good, boy. This thing here I had designed for the stage. It's got all different shapes of diamonds, pear-shaped, square-shaped, screwball, whatever, you know, it's for the stage. This I got tonight for you. You know, really. I got it. Just got it tonight, just like I got the suit for closing. And the reason I'm telling you this, and because I think you ought to know it, you help pay for them. Good night. Only fools, only fools rush in. Oh, but I can't help falling in love. Shall my story? Would it be a sin? Give me that guitar. Like a river flows surely to the sea. Oh my, darn it, some things correct are meant to be. Let's put it together. Take my heart. Let's put it together. Kid made it, took him 6 months. A beautiful.